All right, so I'm going to tell you guys a little story, a little secret of mine, probably most of you don't know about, but I was around the age of maybe 10 or 11. I just sit around all day for hours on end. It's not really a big deal, like 8% of kids do it, they say. But I sit around for hours on end every day just drawing pictures of airfoils, the cross section of an airplane wing. No, my pen literally couldn't touch a paper without me drawing an airfoil. Clark Y, supersonic jets, you name it. I was obsessed with drawing airfoils, and this kind of led to a hobby in model airplanes. I really love models. I'd build these little kits of rubber band powered airplanes. I had remote control electric powered motor airplanes, fly powered airplanes. That didn't work very well. It was a big hobby of mine. I was totally obsessed with airplanes so much that when I started university, I wanted to be an aerospace engineer. I was in the mechanical aerospace engineering program for freshman year. That didn't last either because I became more obsessed with running in college, but I was obsessed with model airplanes and aviation. I was building kits out of balsa wood, large planes like the Lazy Bee, sail planes, gliders, you name it. A lot of remote control airplanes that I'd crash and rebuild again. And it kind of led to this idea of flight and the freedom that flight provides. And now that I travel a lot, especially on international trips in airplanes, I'm always just really appreciative of the gift of flight and kind of the symbol of what flight means in terms of travel nowadays, because travel's this big luxury, it's this big privilege that I've always seen. It's exciting to be able to fly to the other side of the world, to see new places. I think travel is this real gift that gives you new perspective on things, to see how the other world lives, to see how people run in different cultures or different climates, even outside of your own country or your own state. Being able to travel is this huge luxury and privilege, and it wasn't something that I ever thought I'd be able to afford to do. And so now, when I'm on a commercial jet airliner, I'm looking at the airfoil, I'm looking at the wing. I appreciate the mechanics behind it, but the symbol of being able to travel and that as a real gift is something that I never forget. And it's led to this obsession with commercial jet airlines and planes. And because of using my legs to get travel support from races, to have travel support from sponsors, I've been extremely fortunate and extremely lucky to be able to fly on a lot of international plane flights, especially last year. And it's totally not responsible from an environmental standpoint. It's a huge pollution thing. I feel guilty about that. But because I'm doing all these races in Europe and around the world, I accumulated a lot of air time and a lot of air points, and I threw them all towards one airline brand, United. They happen to have a really large hub out of Denver. It makes connections easy. And I built up these loyalty points in United. I also play the credit card game a little bit. But I did these, try to buy the cheapest tickets usually back in coach. And I accumulate a lot of air time, a lot of air miles from these long haul flights. Did my time in the air last year. Again, you're not responsible from an environmental standpoint. Realize that. But I was able to build up my status on United. They've got like a silver, gold, platinum, and then this status, Premier 1K, basically baller status on United. I guess there is a global services which is up higher, but I think you have to buy like really expensive tickets. I didn't buy expensive tickets. I just spent a lot of time in the air. And what happened was, and this is as lame as this sounds, total first world type of luxury. I've always had this dream of being able to fly up in the front of the plane on an international flight. And because of my Premier 1K status now on United, I bought an economy coach ticket and I got a free upgrade from my flight from Chicago to Amsterdam, a free upgrade to United Polaris first class, business class. I'm so excited. Like I've always wanted this, and it's a total luxury. I realize it's really frivolous, but I will be documenting that on the travel vlog here as we're about to take off, and I realize how ridiculous it is, but I'm excited for it because I love planes and I love the idea of travel and flying, and to be able to do it in ultra luxury plush first class, this is really over the top, but I want to document it, and we'll see that journey right now. All right, let's go to the airport. All right, that was a disaster. GoPro fell off. But this is a ticket for my free upgrade to United Polaris business class flight from Chicago O'Hare to Amsterdam, seat 1D. All right, so busy day at Chicago Airport. We're gonna see if we can get into this Polaris lounge. Like I said, super excited because it's my first time ever riding in the front of an airplane. I think the most luxurious thing, hopefully, will be that the seat will go all the way back, not just recline back, but actually go back 180 degrees into a flat bed. So even if you're like 2 meters tall, 1.9 meters tall, 6 foot six, 6 foot three, I'll be able to lie down and stretch my legs out on this long haul overnight flight. That's really important, as well as staying hydrated and be able to move around. But that extra leg room is gonna be really key. See if I can get in the lounge over here. Never been past these doors either. Good snacks. Ooh, nice. Hello, how's it going? You need my passport too? All right. Thank you so much. Have a good day. Thank you. Alright, so I just got a few snacks to tide me over here. I didn't want to get too full before the flight. But, looks pretty good, nice amenities. Hopefully you could power up, get in some work, and then do a little time lapse out the window here and get ready for the flight. Here, the power cord, little sled tray here. Get out the laptop. Business never rests, because money never sleeps. Almost felt a little underdressed today, but I do have my Hoka Havanas on. Hana EM. Nice and comfy travel shoe. Come in the nice plain black color, matches the jeans and jacket, kind of, I guess. Alright, thank you. I believe I am, oh yeah, this will work right here. So this is the legroom situation here. I can't even kick my feet into the well. I got a 15-inch screen, maybe about 15 inches. This little drawer here, side drawer. There's not. For the tray. This goes. Oh, for the TV. So no pajamas, but got the slippers. Alright, in the amenities kit, we got a pen. No. Some sort of shampoo or lotion. Nightshades. Socks. Ooh, toothpaste, and toothbrush. Socks are not Dry Max socks.
crazy.
I'm also gonna do the frowned upon thing of taking my shoes off so I can put these slippers on. My feet don't stink at all though, because I wear Dry Max Sidrunner socks and I'm wearing my Hoka Huponas, so no stinky feet. Pillows here too. This is a firmer pillow and a softer pillow, so. Control the seat to recline. That's the key right there. Hit the manuals. Got a special, put in a special request for vegan meal. We'll see if that's honored on here. It's a very expensive menu. It's very impressive. Quite a bit of turbulence, but of course the treat of being up front, super luxurious, great food, great service. Tried to sleep a little bit more. I did sleep a little bit. It helps when you have a bed like that, and super comfy. It's almost as comfy as my bed at home, so gotta get through customs here and adjust to the time zone, so I'm gonna try to stay up all day today. So nice hop over the pond in the big metal bird. First time in United Polaris business class, it makes a night and day difference. It's like a world of difference to be sitting up front there. Super lucky for that. Probably not gonna happen very often, so fortunate for that free upgrade. Super luxurious and excited to be here.